Welcome back to Let's Play the Talos Principle. I'm BurningDogFace, and this is exactly where I was standing when I loaded my game. Considering I used to be up there, I don't appreciate that very much. Well, at least the elevator's here. I've brought the resolution back up to its original size. Well, because fuck it, it's the end of the game. That's why. I found other methods of dealing with the problem since then. And if those don't work, I'm willing to put up with it. Last time, I used up the last of my red sigils. Listened to Alexandra Drennan's last... I always want to call her Alexandra Brennan, because that's the last name of the main character from Bones, which I used to watch. Dr. Temperance Brennan. Wait, use... No! Let's not do that. I just wanted to put one out. Oh, I can't. I can't back away until I make sure the puzzle is still solved. What the fuck was that? I'm seeing shit. And I hear a bird outside my window. That one's real. Ah, yes, this hot mess. Last time we heard Dr. Drennan's last message. Honestly, this entire time, I had always assumed that Drennan's final message was going to be something along the lines of, "Well, that's it. The program is running. I've done everything I can for you. The rest is up to you. Good luck." Oh god, oh god, oh god! I never thought she would take the time to record something as personal as her last thoughts on the event of her death. Wait. Okay, I'm gonna trap him in there. Okay, that's good to know. I wasn't sure about that. If I block off the jammer from what it's jamming, it stops jamming it. Because that raises a very important question. I don't need to worry about going upstairs, past the turret, right now. All I need to worry about is getting that, mine. Do you mind? Are you there so you're useful for a second? I have to worry about is getting that mine from down there over here. Then when I reset, it will still be dead. And I can just focus on getting myself upstairs with two phantom jammers. But here's the problem. I think I have to have everything set up in advance up here. Because it has to go up here, over here. It's right behind me, yeah. Over here, and into range of that thing. Unless I just hug this corner, I don't think there's anywhere I can stand where the mine won't blow me up. So... well, here's the especially confusing part. In order to set all this off, I have to be over there. So fuck it. I have an idea of how to get started, but that's it. I need the box up there to weigh down the button. Wait. No, I did do that. Fuck. Stop it. I'm also not sure how the mine will behave once it gets up there. Just disable you, put you on top of the box, and I don't think I was even sure until last time if the jammer would rotate to keep pointing at something when I did something to it. Sorry, when I moved it. And it did. When I levitate this thing, it totally does keep pointing at the, Yeah, good, I did pick that back. It does keep pointing at the fan. Oh, I never finished that thought. I never would have imagined that Alexandra Drennan would record her something as personal as her thoughts on the experience of her death. Yes, I can bring this back up. Just gotta be careful about this. Now I go up by myself. There for now. Okay. That's a thing. That's a thing that happened. Now what? Wait. I am not one of the Three Stooges, so... Okay, what am I gonna do? I'm going to... I need two more fans. I have two more fans. This shouldn't be a problem. I just gotta give myself a whole lot of time. And it's hard, and I'm also trying to think about what kind of person it takes to contemplate scientifically and calmly the terms of her own death. The last few messages especially have driven it home that Drennan gave everything for this project. Actually, I have an idea. Oh, I don't know. Okay. Okay, the Phantom fans can go here and here, from here and here. And maybe if I put them back before I... Oh my god, that really needs to stop. If I put them back before I finish recording, I can, they don't have to worry about, like, timing it so badly, because they'll start out there anyway. Oh, shit. Rush me. Fuck. No. Okay, that just kind of did my head in. I can't jam the fan. That's a problem. Oh god, what am I going to do? I mean, I get that in order to get this thing started, I have to jam that. Jam him over here. Go upstairs. Okay, that's a start. I have to start out with that fan jammed. Or, you know, not there. Because I have to be able to get over here. Okay. So I'm gonna leave that there. So that when I start, the Phantom Jammer will be jamming it. Oh, Christ. I come down here with the jammer. The real one. Jam that. And then jam it again over there. Then I come upstairs. Drop down here. Activate the fan. Oh, I haven't gone explaining something very well. Something I had been worried about ever since I saw that there were going to be recording puzzles, you know, with a copy of myself, was this. I need this coffee. I'm not just using myself as a pair of helping hands here. I need to coordinate my timing very carefully. Means I do need to figure out in advance what I'm going to do. Oh god, I'm wasting so much time. Okay. Let's just see what happens if I do it like this. Okay, at 30 seconds, I'm going to pick this thing up, and the fan starts. I guess I just put it there, because... I I could probably just do this. I did not hear a boom. Oh, that helps too. Okay, I can work with this, I think. Don't mind me. Give me a fucking heart attack, why don't you? Okay. Okay. Okay! It wasn't the most elegant solution, but it worked! I'm not entirely certain what happened there. Actually, yeah, it looked like I was right the first time. Because this fan wasn't on, it just kind of sat here. I was wondering if it would try to get back downstairs and return to its original routine, but I guess because it was now in a totally different area, I didn't know what to do. Well, you know what? It may not have been the classiest solution. Thank you. Oh, for God's sake. But it was a solution. Important thing. Step 2. Right. This is actually much simpler. Because all I need to do is get through with the fans. Fans? The phantom whatchamacallits, the jammers. Wait. Oh, that is interesting. And if you return the jammer to being able to see the thing it's supposed to be jamming, it will reactivate. I guess it's just still set to point at that thing. No, this one first. Anyway, I kept bringing up the thing with, Drennan. Because I realized that because she gave everything to this project, she gave everything for me and my brother, and my brothers, I guess you could call us. Brothers and sisters? Maybe there are some that look like ladies. I don't know. Right, I need to be up there first. So... oh. Oh, what am I doing? I can do this much simpler. Okay. I want to do this real quick. And you know what? You can go back over here. Overthinking things. So, first level. Because she dedicated so much of herself to this program, because she thought it would save the world, continue humanity, whatever she was trying to do. I was thinking that if I make it to the real world by some amazing slim chance, I'm going to call myself Alexander. I like to think she would like that. Okay, that's definitely enough time. So, you do your thing, me. Oops. And I'll do my thing. I want to say right now, I don't know how this is going to end. I don't know what's on the next floor. But Burning Dog fans, it's been an honor having you along for the ride. Ah. I was so close. I saw the clouds and the gate, but I couldn't reach it. Somehow I wasn't in the right place at the right time. I'm not ready. I'm not the right version. I think that's a lower number than I've seen him with. I swear I've seen him with sheep version 69.
Why have you ascended the tower? Why have you betrayed my faith in you?
I'm BurningDogFace, and I'll see you in the next episode of Let's Play the Talos Principle. When we face the music.